Hallelujah. Please, let's bow down our heads in prayer. Father, in the name of your Son Jesus, the name that is above every name, the name that demons bows down to, the name that the angelic host adore and worships, we thank you for the gift of salvation. This afternoon, Spirit of the Living God, we're going to speak about you. Who am I to speak about you? I don't have the vocabularies. I don't have the know-how to talk about you. But this afternoon, if you will whisper to me, I will speak passionately about you. I know you glorify Jesus. But because of the statement our Lord Jesus made, that is why I want to talk to you. I want to talk about you to my congregation and to all those who are listening to us. Because there are many fake out there who thought they are working with you and they are not. May those who will hear me, who have been led astray, reconnect back to you and serve you in the beauty of holiness. In the mighty name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. Beloved, we've been looking at Revelation chapter 3, verse 6. Those who have ears, let them hear what the Spirit is saying. But today, I want to divert a little bit and talk about knowing the Spirit that we have received. Knowing the Spirit that we have received. And beloved, the Scripture says that when the time came for Jesus to be received to heaven, a time came for Jesus to be received to heaven where he came from. He came from heaven to earth to show the way. Hallelujah. He came to show us the way to the Father. But after 33 years on the earth, there came a time for him to be taken back to. But before Jesus would go, he made a statement. And there are so many things Jesus said about the Holy Ghost. I like the sound Holy Ghost. In the Holy Ghost, Dr. Kwa will say, in the Holy Ghost. Before Jesus left the earth, he said so many things about the Holy Spirit. Please pay attention to me. Jesus said in his own words, he steadfastly set his face to go to Jerusalem to die. To die. He didn't die by accident. He didn't die by mistake. He knew the day he would die. He told them, you will kill me on this day. The Pharisees and the Sadducees said, we will not kill you on that day. We will kill you a day after. But he died on the very day he said he would die. He defied their word. But before he would die, he said, and so he sent messengers before him, and they went and entered into a village of the Samaritans. I'm talking about when Jesus is about to die and leave the planet Earth, he said to the disciples, go to that village and prepare the way for me to come and preach over there. But Bible said that when he was going, he had Jerusalem on his mind. But the people, I'm reading from Luke chapter 9, from verse 51 to 56. But the people in that village of the Samaritans did not receive Jesus. Jesus has been there before. He has been to Samaritan, the land of Samaria before. You remember when he had the encounter with the woman at the well? They stay about 3 days or 4 days in that Samaria and preach and shook the place. But then this time Jesus was going for his last run. They will never see him again. He's going to die for mankind. He decided to visit this village for the last time and be a blessing to them before he goes. But they did not receive him. They didn't know the time. If they knew that that would be his last visitation to them, they would have paid attention. But they didn't. Because his face was as though he was going to Jerusalem. The people did not receive him because they knew that his mind is set to go to Jerusalem. He was just passing by to be a blessing to them. And when his disciples, James and John, saw that the people were not ready for Jesus, they said to Jesus, "Lord, would you like us to command fire from heaven down and consume these people, even as Elijah did?" This is where our topic comes in. But Jesus came and rebuked them and said, "You did not know what manner or what kind of spirit you are of." How many believers know what spirit they receive? You may talk in tongues, you may be speaking in tongues, but do you know what you received? Tongues is not the final. Some have said that tongues is the physical evidence that you have been baptized by the Holy Spirit. But I tell you the truth, tongues is not the only physical evidence that one is baptized in the Spirit. Tongues is not the only evidence, and it's not even the initial, because there were places that when they received the Holy Spirit baptism, they prophesy and others spoke in tongues. Hallelujah. So you speaking in tongues doesn't justify that you have the Holy Spirit, because there are counterfeits. Hallelujah. Devils also speak in tongues. What did you receive when you received the Holy Spirit? It's like Jesus asking the people, when you went to the wilderness to hear Baptist preach, what did you go to see? Just a man dressed roughly? Or a man with some beard and screaming? No! The man you went to see is a man on fire. Hallelujah. What did you receive when you received the Holy Spirit? Jesus said, "You don't know what spirit you are of." In other words, he's saying the kind of spirit you have received is not for destruction. Hallelujah. The spirit we have received is not for destruction. It's not for cursing. There are other people who propose to have the spirit of God, and they are cursing people if you dare touch them. "For the Son of Man is not come to destroy men's life, but to save them." And they went to another village. Hallelujah. Somebody say they went to another village. These people were so insensitive, they cannot discern that Jesus is coming to bless them. For their personal reasons, they said, "We don't want him over here. We've been going on the street, Joel and myself, and there are some people, we stop them to talk to them, and they said, 'I don't want your Jesus. I don't want Jesus.'" We don't force them, because the Lord himself didn't force himself on anybody. Hallelujah. "Beloved, you did not know what manner of spirit we are of." If I may ask you this afternoon, beloved, if I may ask you this afternoon, what kind of spirit did you receive? The Jews did not know God as a father. They have known him in many different ways. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Chidekenu, Jehovah Rohi. They have known him. Jehovah something. But they do not know him as the Father. So when Jesus came to introduce the Father to them, they could not grasp it. But Jesus did not only come to reveal the Father. Jesus said, apart from the Father, there is somebody who works through me. Amen. Without him, I can do nothing. Amen. I cannot do a thing without this man. Amen. It is expedient. It is for your advantage. It is good for you that I go away for that man to come. Amen. Beloved, when we used to run, it's time for athletics. Everybody will be singing their star runner in their school. And Labone, when we are going, we'll be singing the same thing. When our star runner is on the pitch, we will applaud him. We'll be on our feet. Jesus said, you have seen me. You have seen my miracles. But wait a minute. If I go, the one that will come after me, he's got the Holy Ghost. He will do with you more than I did. The same thing he did through me, he can do through you. Hallelujah. He's the one who worked through me. I cannot by myself do anything. Beloved, pay attention to what I'm saying. This is not my word. Jesus is expecting us to do more than he did. Last week I told you that when Jesus was with them, they didn't have any problem. When they asked them difficult questions, he will answer. When they are broke, he will fix them. When they don't even believe, he will say, sit the people down. Everybody say, sit the people down. Those of you who don't know how to sit down in one church, you are in trouble. Jesus said, before I will feed you, let the people sit down. Tell somebody, sit down. Sit down at one place so that you can be fed. Jesus doesn't feed people who are standing and running away. Tell somebody, sit down. Find a place and sit down so you can be fed the word of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Jesus introduced him to them as a father. And they were troubled and confused. He introduced also the Holy Ghost to them in a dimension they did not know. Listen, Jesus occasionally has imparted his hand, has put his hand on the disciples and imparted something to them, the Holy Ghost into them, and they have gone and performed wonders and miracles and they've come back. But even though they have witnessed, they have tested the work of the Holy Spirit, they still did not know him. Beloved, it is possible that you may be speaking in tongues. It is possible that they may have laid hands on you and you are feeling that you have been slain in the Holy Spirit and yet you don't know the Holy Ghost. Beloved, it is good you go to the ground, but make sure by the time you pick yourself up from the ground, something has happened to you. Hallelujah. Don't just fall down. But when you fall down, something must happen to you. The first time God slain Adam in the garden, Eve came out of him. Glory be to God. The day Jesus was about to be captured in the garden, the book of John said that when the people came, they said, we seek Jesus. And he said, here I am. And when he said, here I am, the scripture said, they all fell down. Hallelujah. The power of the Holy Ghost smeared on them. But when they got up, they were not changed. You may fall down the anointing. They may lay hands on you. They may even slap you with a leg. And you may go down. And you can get up, not change. We see so many times in the church. I am interested in people who fall, and by the time they get up, they are not the same. Hallelujah. Ask somebody, what kind of spirit have you received? In 1991, Dr. Maurice Rulo sent to Ghana Reverend Dorasimi. He was by then in Harare, Zimbabwe. And he used to be director for Morris Rural School of Ministry in West Africa. He came with, in the Holy Ghost, Dr. Somiawa at Accra Trade Fair Pavilion E, La, specifically. Hallelujah. And a whole 1 week, we sat down and these people taught us the work of God. They taught us the word of God. I soak in everything. After the crusade was over, I took the whole set, over 15 cassettes. I shut it myself in my room, and I listened to them over and over and over and over until I was charged. I was drunk in the Holy Ghost. Dr. Kwa taught on the power of the gospel in action, maturity in tongues and wisdom, consecration, hallelujah, and the manifestation of the gospel. Powerful, especially the manifestation of the gospel. I used to know these sermons off head. And then Reverend Dorasimi taught on the Father's vision. I will never forget these sermons. Beloved, it took me to another gear. I was so charged. 1992, I ended up at Damascus Secondary School. And when I went to Damascus Secondary School, the first thing I did is to visit the SU people. We have a place in Damascus called Mecca. Those of you who are Damascans, you will know. And when I went to this place, that's where the SU people were having their prayer meeting. When I joined them, what were they praying about? They said every year, final student died. Some, not all of them. By the time the examination is over, some of the final students will die. It could be O-level students or A-level students. And for years, it's been going on. And these guys have been praying. I joined them to pray. And then after that, my spirit was stirred. I said, listen, I just came from a conference. I have received something. There is something in my spirit. Enough of prayer. Let us go and confront this demon. Hallelujah. There were a lot of, listen, if you don't believe this, ask my brother George Joma. Labi is there. Victor Bruce. Atumaku was there. I can tell you some of the people I can remember. They were strong as you guys, praying fervently that the death will not happen that day, that year, because they were also final students. And I baptized them and I went to the headmaster. I said, headmaster, this is what I've heard, but I am pregnant with something. Hallelujah. I am pregnant with something. And I want us to do something about this demon who is eating the people up. Hallelujah. I can't be here and watch that demon destroy people. He said, Ebenezer, mighty men of God in this nation have passed by. They prayed against this thing, but it's still happening. I said, I'm not disputing what you are saying. But how would you know that their prayers prepare the ground for us? Hallelujah. I said, their prayers prepare the grounds for us. Hallelujah. And the book of Romans chapter 8 tells me that the earnest expectation of the creation waits for the manifestation of the sons of God so that they will be delivered. I said, I am a son of God. Hallelujah. And who knows if I have come to Damascus for such a time like this. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. After many convincing, he said, well, we will give it a go. I said, glory be to God. Call the whole school. So one of the days, they assembled the whole school in Damascus Assembly Hall. And then they said, today, Ebenezer Ablo will minister the word of God to us. I call all my SU guys. I said, be in prayer mood. Come on, be in prayer mood. I have a friend in the, one of our mates is called Basoti. He's a pianist. I said, be on the piano. The whole school, let us sing. Oh, for a thousand songs. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing. Jesus. My gracious Redeemer's praise. The glories of my God and King, the trials of His grace
Oh, they tried.
Jesus. You know, when they reach the second stanza, hear him ye deaf, ye counsels in your losing tongues employed. Ye blind, behold your Savior come and leap. Ye lame for joy and leap. Ye lame for. Whilst they were singing, the Holy Ghost came. And I said, stop singing. Leave the pianist to play. Everybody get up. If you are not a Christian, pray for your life. All Christians begin to pray in tongues. Shakataria kamanta. Lipram paloma. You should come and see Beshe. Everybody praying. Then God passed one of the students. Begin to scream and scream. He's running. He's running. He's running. I say he better run. He ran away. He ran away. Abunsa ran away. He ran away. He ran away. Abunsa ran away. On the third day, he ran away. The fourth day, he ran away. He ran away. He ran away. Ran, ran away. He ran away. Holy Jesus can say. Holy Jesus can say. Hallelujah. Holy, holy, holy Baba. Oh. Holy, holy, holy Baba. Oh. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I said, he better have to run. He ran from the school. He ran. 1 week later, I was a peer student. And I've been traveling all the way from Teaching Wises to Tema Secondary School. 1 week later, I was coming to the school. By the time I reached the entrance to Committee 1 road, no, Committee 2, going to Committee 2, some of my mates were waiting at the gate. It's unusual for them to be there. And I saw from their face. In fact, that day when I was coming, I've already done pray for somebody who collapsed in the I went to school with. I was charged. I was in the Holy Ghost. Anything can happen. Hallelujah. I was in the dangerous spiritual mood. I knew what I received. Glory be to God. You better have to know what you have received. And then when I met them at the gate, they said, Ebenezer, our own classmate died last night. I said, you are kidding. They said, the headmaster has announced it. I said, what happened? They said, last night he was with us revising. Then this morning, the headmaster said, he received a phone call from the father of this guy. Our mate is called Raymond Ganser. He's still alive today, Raymond Ganser. You can find, those of you watching on Facebook or YouTube, you can find out about what names I've mentioned. They will tell you. Victor Bruce, he's still in Tema. PIWC. Labi is in the US. Hallelujah. George Oma is somewhere in Winneba area. You can find out. Listen, my nickname on Tema campus is Bombo, alias Bombo. Glory be to God. Out of that thing, the nickname surface. A foreigner is dying. Glory be to God. So if you have forgotten, you said there is a guy on the internet called, he said he's called Bongo. He got that name from Temasco. What happened? They will tell you the story. Beloved, I went to headmaster. I said, headmaster, this is what I heard. He said, Ebenezer, didn't I tell you? I said, you told me what? I am in a dangerous mood. Please, when you receive the phone call, did you send some people to go and check whether this boy is dead properly or not? He said, that's the thing. I didn't send anybody to go and inquire. And I said, headmaster, you have announced. Can you send some people to this guy's house? Let them go and find out from the parent. And if Raymond Ganser is truly dead, take me to the mortuary. Hallelujah. What are you talking about? I said, I knew what I received. He said, I will send some people. So he sent some of my mates to this guy's house at Tema. Meanwhile, I went to the classroom with my mates. Everybody's crying. I said, there's no need to cry. I had only one female friend. She wasn't even a Christian. Her name is Janja Louise Smith. She's a Liberian. You can ask about her this name. She came to me. She said, Niablo, if this is true, what can you do? I said, Smith, if this is true, God will do a miracle. I am ready to go to the mortuary. Beloved, we were in the school still talking, and we heard a shout, jubilation on the campus. What is happening? This guy is not dead. He's alive. They carry him from the house to the school. Amen. You should come and see. Who made the phone call? Who called the headmaster and said, somebody, we have to do another service for the guy and break the spirit of death over him? Go and ask Adumaku. Listen, Adumaku is in this country. He did ACC here together with us. They were all there. And we sang, Ewurase wuma usaswa enyamenyina rayedi seyeshe usamwejumenyina esese yema usupenyina seyeshe. We have to do service for this. I think that is not enough. People were taking ill. If anybody takes ill, they come and call me. I go to the hospital. Listen, I was going to Tema General Hospital and coming like crazy, because the devil planted fear in the people. But I said, as long as I'm on Tema campus, nobody will die. I don't know if somebody has died after then. There was a particular dormitory in Asfor. They said people don't sleep over there because the beds move. I said, I will sleep there and we'll see if any bed will move. I have to leave one of the day and sleep in that room, and no bed moved. Glory be to God. No bed moved. What are you talking about? I said, I received something. What have you received? I received something. And I, listen, that thing which I received has not left me. Hallelujah. I said, it has not left me. I still have it. What did you receive when you received the Holy Spirit? Jesus said, it is expedient. It's just to your advantage. I am limited. If I am in Nazareth, I cannot be in Capernaum. If I'm Capernaum, I cannot be in any other city. Decapolis and be in Samaria at the same time. But Jesus said, when I go, I will send somebody. It's called the Paracletus, the Comforter, the Holy Ghost, your helper. When he comes, he will show you things that you never know. Hallelujah. Beloved, I want to emphasize on the importance of the Holy Spirit. There are many people who have other spirits and they think it's the Holy Spirit. Many years back, there was one elder who was standing in front of me and talking water and salt. And he was saying it's from the Holy Ghost. I look at him and I said, the Holy Ghost, I know, he's not stupid. Hallelujah. What you are talking, it doesn't hold water. Obadiah will say, it doesn't hold water. And you are saying this is from the Holy Ghost. Not the Holy Ghost I know. Maybe the Holy Ghost you know. Hallelujah. What did you receive? Ask somebody, what did you receive? You see, Paul went to Ephesus and he saw some believers. And he said, have you heard of the Holy Ghost since you believe? And they said, if there is any Holy Ghost, we have not heard. He said, what were you baptized with for God's sake? They said, John the Baptist. He said, we were baptized in the baptism of John. He said, John baptism is good, but there is another one. Hallelujah. There is another one. And he inspired them. He told them what that spirit, what the Holy Ghost has been doing with them. And they said, we want it. We want what you have. And Bible said, he laid hand on them. And when he laid hand on them, they caught it and they begin to prophesy, spoke with tongues. Beloved, the tongues is is what you used to do. The tongues is what you used to start the car. Hallelujah. Don't just do drive, zoom, and take off. Hallelujah. So if you're a tongue speaker and you have just hidden your tongues, and once in a while you are coming to church and you polish it and you come and join us, you better get ready. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost is mother. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. What have you received? Ask somebody, what have you received? John chapter 5 from verse 17 and 19. Skip verse 18 and read 17 and 19 for us. John chapter 5, verse 17.
John chapter 5. But Jesus answered them, "My Father has been working until now, and I have been working." 19. Then Jesus answered and said to them, "Most assuredly I say to you, the Son can do nothing of himself, but what he sees the Father do, for whatever he does, the Son also does in like manner."
Hallelujah. There is another time Jesus said, "I can of myself do nothing." Me, Jesus, I cannot do nothing. But it is the Spirit that worketh in me that does the work. Hallelujah. And this is the Spirit that Jesus has given to us. Beloved, let us wake up. Those of you who have been doing ministry with all junky spirit, there is a better spirit. The Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is not contaminated. When you have the Holy Ghost, you don't push people's neck. You don't slap people in the face. When you have Holy Ghost, you don't say, "Ukla wase fi bebeglo." Ukla wase fi wase bifi bebeglo. No. Holy Spirit talks specific. Hallelujah. And I call him, please continue with me in John chapter 14, verse 15 to 18. Please, I just want to lay the foundation today and we'll continue. I will spend this somewhere into June, July. I want us to spend time on this Holy Spirit, this gift of the Holy Spirit God has given to us. So the young ones, if you don't know the Holy Spirit, you better listen. You have to desire the Holy Spirit.
John chapter 14, verse 15 to 18. "If you love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper, and he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you."
Hallelujah. Please, let's read verse 17 together. Let's read verse 17 on the screen. He said, "Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it sees him not, neither knoweth him, but
ye know him."
Stop it. Some few days before, Jesus said, "You don't know the Spirit you have received." But in this verse, he was telling the same disciples, after he has given them a little bit experience, they've gone to cast some demons and come back, and they were rejoicing. Jesus gave them a taste of the Holy Ghost, and they went and preached and did some miracles. Jesus could boldly say that the world does not know this Holy Spirit, but you know him. If you are a believer, you should know the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Do you know him? Do we know the Holy Spirit? Jesus said, "You know him because he dwells with you." Do we know the Holy Ghost? Beloved, one of the things I struggle to get in terms with is the Holy Ghost. You may know the Holy Spirit theologically, doctrinally. I used to know the Holy Spirit by doctrines. I went to SU. They taught us about the Holy Ghost. I read every book I read about the Holy Ghost. But I didn't know him. I knew him by head knowledge. Until God sent those men, Larry Rovat and all those people. And I saw the manifestation of the Holy Ghost. And I said, I want that. When they did the anointing service, something happened to me. I began to change. I used to wake up in the morning and I could feel something changing in the inside. I used to go to Mrs. Ablo, Mrs. Doris Ablo, Reverend Dr. Seth Ablo's wife. I used to and I said, Ma, something is happening to me in the inside. Can somebody explain it to me? Something is happening to me in my inside. Can somebody explain it to me? And she will say, continue to pray. Glory be to God. Continue to. Beloved, I'm not telling you a story. There is a guy on Facebook called Open Heavens, but we call him Pastor Niamu Dodu. Hallelujah. He's in the US now. He was in Bible school. I wasn't in Bible school. Sometimes we go and do house visitation together. There was a time we were going to do house visitation, and I told him, when we go, this and this and this will happen. He said, how do you know? I said, listen, I haven't lost my touch with heaven. Glory be to God. Even though I don't call myself a prophet. Some of you calling yourself a prophet, and you have never even seen the move of the Holy Spirit before. You have pastors all around calling yourself prophets. We have seen things. God have used us. But we don't call ourselves prophets. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Beloved, when we went to this home and we begin to pray, their own home, we begin to pray in their house, nobody could stand. They were all on the floor. Hallelujah. There was such power. Listen, God does not use a man until he gives him experience. Everybody say experience. God will not use any man until he gives him experience. And those little experiences he gave me, they all count. Hallelujah. I look back and I said, God, is that not what David said? He said, you gave me experience with the lion. You gave me experience with the deer. You will give me this Goliath to me. Hallelujah. Before God will send Moses to Egypt, he gave him the fire bush experience. He turned his very rod into snake. He said, grab it, and the snake became rod again. He said, put your hand under your armpit or in the process. He did, and it became leprosy. He said, put it back again. He said, listen, this tree is enough. Hallelujah. God will not use a man without giving him experience. You have an experience. Hallelujah. What did you receive? What kind of Holy Ghost you receive? The ghost of who? I receive the ghost of Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost. The other man will say, Papa Kokoe. I receive Papa Kokoe. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I like the way God says it. It's a mumo kong kong. Mumo kong kong. Glory be to God. Then some people will say, soon soon, once and once. I like the sound. It says, soon soon, once and once. When we say once, do you know what? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Soon soon, once and once. That's what then some people will say. What kind of spirit did you receive? Jesus said, you know him. Tell somebody you know him. Beloved, I'm winding you up. You better have to know this Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is not only giving us for us to speak in tongues. There is tongues is primary. It's a primary stage. Hallelujah. He who speaks in tongues edifies himself. What do you edify yourself for? Go to the gym. Those who are in the gym, some of them are wasting their energy over there. They just go and pump their energy. They don't use it for anything. The athletes who go to the gym, they build up. They use it for competitions. It's not worth pumping your muscles if you have nothing to use it for. He who speaks in unknown tongues edifies. John chapter 16, verse 7 to 14. Please, Edda. Now, I told you we'll be talking more about the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit. Because we have to know what we receive. We better have to know what we receive and begin to walk as such. Jesus said, John chapter 16 from verse 7 to 14. Listen, Jesus said, it is your advantage. It is expedient that I go away. You should clap your hands that I am going. Because if I go, the one that will come after me, he will be in you. He will be with you wherever you go. He will not leave you comfortless. He will not leave you powerless. The church of Jesus Christ was not born anemic. Today, many areas, the church is anemic. Powerless, empty. Christianity, you were not born anemic. You were not born anemic. You were not born powerless. You were born powerful. Hallelujah. Edda, please read for us.
Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Helper will not come to you. But if I depart, I will send him to you. And when he has come, he will convict the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment. Of sin, because they do not believe in me. Of righteousness, because I go to my Father and you see me no more. Of judgment, because the ruler of this world is judged. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. He will glorify me, for he will take off what is mine and declare it to you.
Hallelujah. I want us to stress some few things before our time is far spent. Jesus said, I still have many things to say to you. Everybody say, I still have many things.
I still have many things
to say to you.
To say to you.
And he said, but you cannot bear them now. However, when he, the Spirit of truth. Everybody say, the Spirit of truth. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth. There is no lie. There is no guile in the Holy Ghost. How come we hear all kinds of lies today? The Spirit of truth. This is how we know. When we say somebody is kululu, somebody is not straight. The Spirit of God is not using somebody. Even though there can be some manifestations, we know. Because the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth. He said, by their fruits, you can know them. The tares and the wheat, they look alike. But when they bear fruit, you can see which one is a tear, which one is a wheat. By their fruits. They look alike. Dr. Hua will tell you, the wheat bends when it's harvest time. The tares stand tall. They don't bend. Glory be to God. They are rebellious. They don't live for God. They say something today and tomorrow they change. The Holy Ghost is a Spirit of truth. It will make us walk in truth and live a truthful life. Then another thing the Holy Spirit, Jesus said, he said, he will guide you into all truth. The Holy Spirit guides into truth. He will, Holy Spirit guides into truth. So if you really have a genuine Spirit of God, You will start looking for the right churches to go. Hallelujah. He will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak. And he will tell you things to come. Everyone say, he will tell you things to come. Say it again. Listen. You know, Christians who have been chasing after prophets and prophets, they are dead Christians. They cannot hear from God. So they want somebody to hear for them. The script, please underline that word. The scripture said that the Holy Spirit will tell you things to come. I can tell you many times things Holy Spirit have spoken to me, and I say it before they happen. Please don't come and look for me because I said, sometimes I say things and you think, oh, there is your man in Barking said he's a prophet, so I better have to go to his church. You'll be disappointed. Hallelujah. Sometimes Holy Spirit speaks to me. I can tell you countless number of times. But I remember 1997 in this country. I was living in Plateau and going to school in Credit College. And before I would join the train, Holy Spirit, I used to get off at Whitechapel and then would take another train to New Cross Gate and connect from there to Croydon. But this time, when I entered into Plateau Station and I was waiting for the train, Holy Spirit told me clearly, don't go through Whitechapel. Go through Vidoria. And when you go to school, something will happen. I started praying, Holy Spirit, what is that thing that will happen? Holy Spirit didn't tell me exactly what will happen. But I said, when you go to Croydon College, something will happen. I'm talking about 97. I joined the train. We passed by Whitechapel. And I was expecting. I was praying in tongues. And that nobody knows. I was just talking. And then when we got to Aldgate, somebody in our coach collapsed. And when they were frantically, because we already entered into the tunnel, and this man was shaking and everything, they were calling first aider. There's no first aider. I went to this man, and I said, I am a Christian. If you don't mind, I will pray for you. He didn't even have the mouth, but he gave me the go-ahead. I picked this man, and I began to speak in tongues. Kara, Masanda, Labranta. I began to call the spirit of this man, the soul of this man, to come back. By the time we got to the next station where they stopped, they have made arrangement and ambulance and everything. By the time the ambulance came, this man was perfectly well. But the paramedical staff said, we still have to treat him and find out if there is the reason why he collapsed. The man shook my hands and I continued my journey. I went through Victoria and I went to school. When I went to school, I told one of our lecturers that before I left home, I'm a man of God. God told me that something will happen in this school. I don't know exactly. God didn't tell. He made a laugh of it because he's not a believer. He's a dead man living. So he didn't. But in the afternoon, we had siren. Ambulance, fire brigade and everything came. One of the buildings in the school caught fire. After that, this man remembered. He came looking for me. He said, Ebenezer, is that what we were talking about? I said, I don't know, but God told me something will happen. He said, yes, something is happening. Don't you hear? One of the buildings has caught fire, and that's why the fire brigade are here putting it off. I said, glory be to God. Next time when I talk, listen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. But it's not all the time. I'm not saying because I've said it, you should come and ring me. I remember there was a ministry I used to help, and then occasionally, when the anointing comes, he gives me word for specific people, names and whatever their problem is. And I begin to speak to them. People would deliberately call me and say, Pastor, pray with me. And then after I've prayed with them, they said, Pastor, what did you see? I said, I didn't see anything. Glory be to God. I didn't see anything. Don't turn me into a fortune teller. Glory be to God. I'm not a fortune teller. As I hear, I speak. You can do the same. The Spirit of God wants to do the same with you. We will stop over here. We will continue next week. Hallelujah. Ask somebody, what kind of spirit did you receive? Ask somebody. You may be listening to us. What kind of a ghost did you receive? Did you receive the Paracletos? the Holy Ghost, the same Spirit I received, I understood perfectly what Jesus said. Jesus said, it is for my advantage that he has to physically leave this world. Because if he doesn't go, this sweet Holy Ghost will not come. And when he comes, he will do certain things. We'll be looking at some of the things he will be doing step by step. What the Holy Spirit will do with us. So if you are a Christian and you have been speaking to in tongues and it's a genuine one, I applaud you. I'm shaking your hands now. Congratulations. If you have a genuine tongues, but use it. Use it. Because it's just the key to the supernatural. It's a key into the supernatural. Hallelujah. Build yourself in your most Holy Ghost, holy faith. Speak, talk them tongues. Dr. Kwa will say, talk them tongues. Talk them tongues until you don't know where you are anymore. And leave the times in the hands of God. Leave the times in the hands of God. Just build yourself up. There are 9 ways the Holy Spirit manifests himself through people. And very soon you will start seeing the Holy Spirit manifesting in your life. Let's bow down our heads.